Hey all, welcome back to today's session. Today we will be dealing with some questions based on stationary waste, stretch string, open pipe, closed pipe, etc. Okay, now coming to the first question. Equation of a stationary wave in a stretch string is given by y is equal to 2 sin 2 pi x by 3 cos 20 pi t in centimeter. Find amplitude of each amplitude of component wave and speed of each component wave. This is a question. While you have a question like this, always compare with the standard equation. I told you there are four forms of standing wave equations or stationary wave equations. It should be a product of kx term and harmonic kx term and omega t term. So if I compare with the standard equation, I have y is equal to 2a. Here it is sine kx cos omega t. Cos omega t. So 2a represents total amplitude of the wave, where a represents amplitude of each component wave. So from this I'll be getting 2a equal to 2 centimeter, unit is centimeter here. So a is equal to 1 centimeter. So amplitude of each component wave is 1 centimeter. First question answer. Now coming to second question, speed of each component wave. We got a stationary wave by superposition of two traveling waves or progressive waves, and speed of each wave is given by omega by k. Look at omega. Omega is nothing but the coefficient of time here. Omega. K is nothing but coefficient of x here. So substituting I'll be getting 20 pi divided by 2 pi by 3. Okay, pi pi cancels, this cancels. So we'll be getting 3 will come to the numerator. So I'll be getting 30 again unit is centimeter per second. So this is the answer to the second part. Now we'll move on to the second question. Okay. Now coming to question number 2, I'll read the question. In a stationary wave, all the particles, option A, on either side of the node and either side of the node will be in phase. In between two nodes will vibrate in phase. In between two antinodes vibrate in phase. Of the medium vibrate in phase. Okay, so let us draw the pattern of stationary waves. So stationary wave pattern, roughly we can draw the stationary wave pattern like this. I told you, suppose I consider waves, particles in one loop, they will be vibrating in the upward direction, means other loop will be vibrating in the downward direction. So this is node and this is node. Okay, so all the particles of the medium vibrating phase is not a correct option. Okay, because different particles will be in different state of vibration, so that is not correct. Now in between two nodes vibrating phase, let us consider in between two antinodes, third option. So this is an antinode and this is an antinode. In between two antinodes, no, they in between two antinodes, suppose I consider this particle, they are moving in the upward direction, and this is moving in the downward direction, so they are not in phase, so that is also not true. Okay, in between two nodes vibrating phase, let us consider in between two nodes, okay, two adjacent nodes, okay, in between two, actually it should be adjacent nodes, they vibrate in phase. Okay, so in between two adjacent nodes vibrate in phase. Okay, so that is the most appropriate correct answer. On either side of the node will be in phase. No, on either side of the node means one is moving in the upward direction, other one is moving in the downward direction, so that is not in phase, so that is also not true. So the most appropriate answer is option B. Now passing on to the third question. Okay, passing on to the third question. Let us go to the third question. Third question is, the equation y is equal to 0.2 sin 100 pi t cos 4.5x represents. Look at the form. You already studied progressive wave and stationary wave, and just compare. It is a product of omega t and kx harmonic function. So it should be, what is the answer? Stationary wave. In majority of the questions, they will not be asking you it is a progressive or stationary wave. They will be asking you like this. It is a progressive wave of wavelength so this much. It is a stationary wave of wavelength this much. So your answer should be it is a stationary wave. So the answer is it is a stationary wave. Stationary wave. Let us look at all possible questions. Stationary wave. Look at all possible questions. Omega. Omega is nothing but 100 pi. So from this frequency is equal to omega by 2 pi. So which is equal to 50 hertz. Okay. Again I am writing this as centimeter. Okay. Again k. K is nothing but here k is equal to 2 pi by lambda. Right. Which is equal to coefficient of this one. So 4.5. So from this I will be getting lambda is equal to again 4. Lambda is equal to 2 pi divided by 4.5 centimeter. This will be the value for lambda. Again, if it is given as a decimal point, put pi is equal to 3.14 and substitute and find the answer. Now coming to the component of each amplitude. Amplitude of wave is nothing but 2a. 2a is the amplitude of the stationary wave, which is equal to 0.2. Therefore, amplitude of the component wave is 0.1 centimeter. So these are the parameters. It may be asked in different versions. They will be giving you options as it is a stationary wave of frequency 50 Hertz. It is a stationary wave of time period 0.02 seconds. It is a stationary wave of wavelength this much. It is a stationary wave with amplitude of each component wave this much. So these are the possible questions. Now we will pass on to the fourth question. Okay. Now the fourth question is, when a string vibrates in n loops, find the number of notes, number of antinotes, length of the string if lambda is the wavelength. So n loops. Let us consider generally say some 2-3 loops. Okay. Suppose we have 2 loops here for to find the answer. Suppose we have 2 loops means 3 notes and 2 antinotes. So n loops means n plus 1 notes and n antinotes. One more nokkam. 2 loop aagumbam 1 2 3 alle node 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 alle. Appo 1 2 3 3 notes undu. Appo n loops aagumbam n plus 1 notes undu. Adu pole ethriya n antinotes undu. ഇനി ഇത് ലാംഡ ബൈ 2 ആണ് ഓക്കേ അല്ലേ ലാംഡ ബൈ 2 ലാംഡ ബൈ 2 അപ്പോൾ രണ്ട് ലൂപ്പ് ആകുമ്പം എൽ ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു 2 ടൈംസ് ലാംഡ ബൈ 2 എന്നാണ് മൂന്ന് ലൂപ്പ് ആകുമ്പോഴോ എൽ ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ എന്താ പറയുക 3 ടൈംസ് ലാംഡ ബൈ 2 എന്നാണ് അപ്പോൾ എൻ ലൂപ്സ് ആകുമ്പോൾ എന്താ പറയുക എൽ ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു എൻ ടൈംസ് ലാംഡ ബൈ 2 ഓക്കെ ഓർ ഇപ്പോൾ ലാംഡ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ഇസ് ടു ഫൈൻഡ് ലെങ്ത് ഓഫ് ദ സ്ട്രിംഗ് ഓർ എൽസ് യു വിൽ ബി ഗിവൺ ലാംഡ വാട്ട് ഇസ് ലാംഡ ഇൻ വേവ് ലെങ്ത് ഓഫ് ദ വേവ് പ്രൊപ്പഗേറ്റിംഗ് ഓർ വേവ് ലെങ്ത് ഓഫ് ദ വേവ് ഫോംഡ് എന്ന് ചോദിക്കും അപ്പോൾ ലാംഡ ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു 2 എൽ ബൈ എൻ ദിസ് ഇസ് ഗിവൺ ഇൻ യുവർ എൻ സി ആർ ടി ഫോർ എൻത്ത് മോഡ് എൻ സി ആർ ടി ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ഗിവൺ ലൈക്ക് ദിസ് ഫോർ എൻത്ത് മോഡ് ദ കറസ്പോണ്ടിംഗ് വേവ് ലെങ്ത് ഓഫ് ദ സ്റ്റേഷനറി വേവ് ഫോംഡ് ഇൻ എ സ്ട്രെച്ച്ഡ് സ്ട്രിംഗ് ഇസ് 2 L by N, where N represents either Nth mode or N number of loops. Okay, so this is the answer. Passing on to fifth question. Okay, now coming on to the fifth question. A standing wave with 3 nodes and 2 antinodes are formed between 2 atoms separated at 1.21 angstrom. Find wavelength of the waveform. Okay. So, 3 nodes and 2 antinodes. Let us draw the pattern. 3 nodes and 2 antinodes. Appa etra loop a? 2 loop. Node, node, node. Alle. Ini enda? Total separation is 1.2 angstrom. Okay. So, 1.2 angstrom is equal to enda varaya 2 lambda by 2. Because id lambda by 2. This is also lambda by 2. Right? അപ്പൊ 2 ലാംഡ ബൈ 2 അപ്പൊ ലാംഡ ഈസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു എത്രയാ പറഞ്ഞത് 1.2 ആംസ്ട്രോം ഓക്കെ അപ്പൊ ഇത് വേവ് ലെങ്ത് ഓഫ് വേവ് ഫോംഡ് ആ ചോദിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത് ഇനി ഓർ ദ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ കുഡ് ബി ഫൈൻഡ് ഡിസ്റ്റൻസ് ബിറ്റ്വീൻ 2 സക്സസീവ് നോഡ്സ് ഡിസ്റ്റൻസ് ബിറ്റ്വീൻ 2 സക്സസീവ് നോഡ്സ് ഓർ ആന്റി നോഡ്സ് അങ്ങനെയും ചോദിക്കാം ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ആന്റി നോഡ്സ് two successive nodes or antinodes. Then what will be your answer? Lambda is 1.2 angstrom. Appo second question, lambda is 1.2 angstrom. Find lambda first. Then distance between two successive nodes or antinodes is nothing but what is the answer? Lambda by 2. So 1.2 angstrom divided by 2. So what is your answer? 0.6 angstrom is the correct answer. Okay. So this is the answer for the fifth question. So please remember the pattern whenever number of nodes and number of antinodes are given to you. Always try to draw the pattern. It is applicable for all types of stationary wave questions. Try to draw the pattern, then find the corresponding answer. Okay, so this is the answer to the fifth question. I hope it is okay. Now the sixth question is, a wire under tension vibrates with a fundamental frequency of 600 Hertz. If length of the wire is doubled and radius is halved, new fundamental frequency will be. How will you do this? What are the data given to you? Length is given to you given that radius is double. So what is the general equation fundamental frequency? F is equal to 1 by 2L root of T by mu. So given that there is no change for tension here. But given that length of the wire is half and mu mass per unit length. we have discussed while doing this velocity of transverse mechanical wave, this can also be written as T by pi r square rho. Okay, pi r square rho, because mu is, I am writing here, mu is mass per unit length. Okay, mass is nothing but pi r square rho L divided by L. So, LL cancels. Okay, so we have to find a new fundamental frequency. So, F is equal to, initially F is equal to 600 Hertz. So, this value is equal to 600 Hertz. Okay, now F dash, let us find F dash. F dash is equal to 1 by 2 into length is made twice. Again, root of T by radius is half, so pi into, this is nothing but r by 2 the whole square into rho. Okay, so substituting this 2 square will come to the numerator, so 1 by 2 into, again 1 by 2l into root of, this is nothing but 2 square into T by, actually it is pi r square rho. Okay, so again root of 2 square is nothing but 2 here, 2 2 cancels. So finally you will be getting the answer as 1 by 2L into root of, what is the answer, T by pi r square rho. So F dash is equal to initial frequency F itself, so answer will be 600 Hertz. Okay, another shortcut for doing this problem is, suppose we have only 1 minute while doing entrance questions. Okay, so shortcut for doing this problem is, I am just rubbing the question here. Okay, I hope the question is in your mind. The question is initial frequency 600 Hertz, length of the wire is doubled and radius is half. So I am just rubbing the question. In one step you can do the question. So please remember, how will you do this in one step? Okay, remember the equation, F is equal to 1 by 2L into, anyway you have to need the, you have to remember the equation, pi r square rho. So I can write F by 600 divided by F dash. Okay, F dash is equal to, this is nothing but L2 divided by L1 into root of nothing but R1 square divided by, sorry, R2 square divided by R1 square. Root of R1 square or R2 square divided by R1 square. Okay, so substituting this, length is made 2L. Okay, radius is, so length is made 2L. So mindfully calculate, so it is 2 times radius is made half. Now root of 1 by 2 square, mentally calculate. So 1 by 2 square is 4, now 1. So from this I will be getting F dash is equal to 600 Hertz. You can adopt either this method or this method. This actually, this depends on the convenience of the student who is doing this. Okay, I'm not insisting on this method or this method. It is up to you. You can choose any method which is convenient to you. So that is the solution for the sixth question. I hope it is clear. Seventh question. The ratio of two frequencies in a stretch string is 350 Hertz and 420 Hertz. Find the fundamental frequency. Now we know that in a stretch string, the frequencies are in the ratio because all harmonics are present. The first one was F0, second 2F0, 3F0. So frequency ratio is 1 is to 2 is to 3 is to 4 is to etc. So whenever two frequencies are given to you, always find the ratio. Okay. So ratio of, actually it should be ratio of two adjacent frequencies. Adjacent tharanam nalladhu correct aavullu. Okay. Appa ratio kandupidikka. Appa 315 as to 420. 315 as to 420, 5 kattiyum 63 varum. Ivada 5 kattiyum 84 varum. Again njan 3 kattiyum 21 varum. Ivada again kattiyum 3 kattiyum 28 varum. So this is nothing but 3, this is nothing but 4. In the word, third harmonic on 315, fourth harmonic on 420. Appa third harmonic is equal to 315, nth harmonic. Appa F0 equal to 315 divided by 3. Okay, so it is nothing but 105 Hertz is the fundamental frequency. So whenever in any stationary wave question, adjacent frequencies are given to you, always check what is the ratio. Then compare that ratio with the fundamental frequency. That ratio should be an integer. That integer should be integer into that fundamental frequency should be the corresponding value. So answer will be 105 Hertz. So that is answer.